Okay, komm drauf. Ne? Lombard. Der kommt drauf, mehr hin, bin Lombard. Tammy. Komm drauf, kipp bald, komm, bin es genug. Ne? Natürlich, dann hört sich das. Check du, sogar Park kommt zu sein. Bin ja nicht. Geleben hohe Nala. Jan, mir kommt Kit, du. Man jut mein Dai. Jo, ne, an der Kot, jo, ne, Adit. Mir Priot allein, ne, Patschupan, mir kein Jo. Mir Lo, ja, ne, Patschupan, kam lang Kittrung, an der Kotrung, Adit. Dann mit Scheißen ab, ne? Bei Jam neu. And like I said in this morning, I mean, here when we are here in the monastery, we try to be peaceful. Yeah. If you see anger comes up, you know, then hurry out. Yeah. Don't let the anger out on anybody. Yeah? I don't want to see two dogs fighting. Yeah, because the person, you know, that fights back, yeah, is also guilty. Yeah, both of them are guilty. Yeah, the person who attacks is guilty. The person who fights back is guilty. Yeah, if there's only one attacker, you know, then it's his problem. Yeah? So try to be peaceful because the anger is in our heart. Yeah. Somebody angered us, you know, that means somebody, you know, put his foot on our toes, yeah? And of course that hurts when somebody puts his foot on our toes, yeah? Well, that does hurt, you know, but then we keep, you know, because we are practitioners, so we keep with the hurt, yeah? And see, you know, and see the anger, you know, I mean, it is not pleasant, yeah? And it always based on wrong view, yeah? And that's what we have to investigate afterwards, yeah? If you see, you know, you got angry, yeah, I mean, investigate it, yeah? Afterwards, yeah? Once you calm down again, yeah? And then investigate it, yeah? Well, what kind of, which toe did he, yeah? Did he get at, yeah? And then try to get that toe out of the way. Yeah, Michelle, yeah? I'm trying to be peaceful here, yeah? If we can't be peaceful here, you know, in a perfect place, you know, for meditation, I mean, how is the world looking like? Huh? I mean, when you look at the world, it's already a mess, you know, war here, war there, you know. People don't like each other, shoot each other, you know, bomb each other, yeah. I mean, we don't want that, yeah. We want to be, you know, find the peacefulness in our heart, yeah. And actually, when you go into samadhi, you find this peacefulness. Yeah? There's no doubt about it, yeah? So, and if the anger comes up because we do some super practice, then I said, you know, I told you before, you should be very careful, yeah? Because the anger instantly latches out, not while we're doing a super practice, but after we do the super practice, yeah? Remember this, yeah? Please? What shall I do with my monks, yeah? I mean, they use good wood for firewood, yeah? Shall I use my monks, yeah? Yeah? My good monks for firewood? Huh? What do you think? Huh? Shall I send you down to hell? Huh? And to be burned there. Have a little bit of wisdom, yeah? I know it's too much ass, yeah? Having wisdom, yeah? We only have knowledge, yeah? And we have lots of knowledge, yeah? And we have lots of views, and we have lots of opinions, yeah? But wisdom is something that we all lack, yeah? And wisdom is developed, for instance, through reflection, through the daily reflection. Remember that? Have you ever heard that, me talking about? Yeah? In the afternoon or in the evening, do your daily reflection, what happened, and then you see what happened. And that's how we start, yeah, developing wisdom. Yeah? through our reflection. What did we do? Yeah. What did we think? What kind of feelings came up? Yeah. And then go to the next activity. Is that so difficult? We tend to forget it or we skip over it, you know? We don't like to see this reflection, this daily reflection, as I told you before, it's an eye-opener, yeah? It opens up our eyes to see what we are doing, why we are doing, and what kind of results our doing has, yeah? That's what it is for, yeah? And what do you think investigation is? Yeah? Investigation of the body is an eye-opener, yeah? To see, you know, first of all, that the body is not us, yeah? And then secondly, you know, to see that the body is full of shit, yeah? It's an eye-opener. And once you see that the body is full of shit, you don't want to have another one, yeah? Why would you carry, you know, 60 or 80 kilograms of shit with you, yeah? Nobody would do that, yeah? You remember the comparison. Yeah? I mean, if you have a nice soft pillow, yeah, and somebody tells you to open it up and said, "Why? No, it's white. It is soft and warm. Yeah, that's all what I need. Yeah, and that's how we look at the body. It's soft and warm. Yeah, isn't it? Yeah, and that's why we like it. Yeah, just like the pillow. And so somebody said, yeah." Keeps on forcing us, you know, to open up the pillow. And then, yeah, finally we open it up and we see it's full of shit, yeah? Nobody will close it again and put his head on it. Or, if there's a person then who will put his head back on it when he knows that the pillow is full of shit, you know, I mean, then he is here at the wrong place, yeah? And that is the same with the body, you know, open it up, yeah, you see, yeah, it's loathsome. Inside it is completely loathsome. Yeah? We don't like these things. Yeah? We don't like the things that go out of our body. Yeah? And we don't like, but we like the things that go into our body, yeah, or that the things that we can do with our body, yeah. But we don't like the things that come out of our body. Not the hair, you know, when it falls off. Huh? Not the teeth when they get out. Yeah. Not the nails when they are clipped off. Yeah. We don't like them. We find them disgusting. Yeah? That's where our wrong view about the body is. Yeah? Once you finish the investigation of the body is just neutral. It just is the way it is. Yeah. But there's no attachment for it, yeah, and there's no loathsomeness. Yeah? But in order, you know, to find out, you know, the investigation of the body, you know, we first have to, yeah, see the loathsomeness of the body. It's not that we have to make it loathsome, what a lot of people think, yeah. You don't have to make the body loathsome. Just open it up and you will throw up, yeah. Unnatural, yeah. Oh, you know, I mean, just put your hair in the soup, you know, or in the meal, and you don't like to eat the meal anymore. Huh? I mean, it's nobody, you don't have to do it loathsome, you find it loathsome, yeah? Just like you find it attractive, yeah? That is the nature about the body, yeah? And that is our attachment of the body, and when you see it, we find it attractive or we find it loathsome. I mean, that's where greed and hate comes from. So, greed and hatred is rooted within this body, yeah? And you have to do investigation until you see it, yeah? And of course, you know, I mean, when you do the body investigation, just like I said before, yeah? Find it loathsome, you know, I mean, there's a lot of irritation in the beginning, maybe only irritation coming up, and then sooner or later the anger will rise, yeah? We see something that we don't like to see, yeah? And that always makes us angry. Yeah? Look in the world or try to remember in the world. If we see somebody doing something wrong, that means if we see somebody doing something that we don't like to see, makes us angry. That's where the anger comes from. Yeah? And as I said this morning, there's nobody right and there's nobody wrong. Yeah? It's just, you know, both people have different kind of views. Yeah? And then they clash together. The only thing that right view is, you know, I mean, as the Lord Buddha pointed it out, is seeing dukkha, seeing the origin of dukkha. That is right view, and seeing the things as they are. That is right view. But anything else in this world, you know, it's neither wrong or right, So I mean, you can fight over it, you know. And when you look at the world, they fight constantly over it, He did something wrong. He did something wrong. I mean, they accuse each other of doing something wrong, And both of them are wrong, Because both of them have wrong views. Right view is, you know, also looking at the fourth noble truth, Sila Samadhi Panya, keeping our precept, not harming anybody, not taking what is not given, no sexual misconduct, no alcohol and drugs, no lies and harsh speech. That are the five precepts. When we here, we have the eight precepts. No food after 12 o'clock, but here in the monastery, only one meal, and then it's over, No high beds and no ornaments and perfumes and so on, watching shows. These are the eight precepts. And no, from sexual misconduct to sexual, no sexual conduct at all. And we keep them when we are here, And it's quite easy to keep, I mean, it is quite easy to keep if you're interested in practice, or if you would be interested in practice, And all these constant complaints, this is not good, that is not good, We need to change this, we need to change that, We constantly need to change something because our heart, why? When you're in samadhi, there's nothing that you need to change, If it is hot, it's hot, If it's cold, it's cold, If it is rain, it's rainy, You don't want to change anything. When you come out of samadhi, you want to change this and this. That is not right. This should be better. That should be done and that should be done and so on and so on and so on. There are a lot of things, we need to change. We need to change rules as well, Like I saw this morning, washing the bowl, we need to change it, Why? Because we are dissatisfied. We only need to change things when we are dissatisfied, And then we change something, and then we are satisfied for a moment, then we change the next thing, and then we are satisfied for a moment. So we keep changing and changing and changing, Not being satisfied. I mean, our principal motivation should be satisfied with whatever is given to us, Should be satisfied, with whatever the things are, That's what we should be satisfied, But we are not. But we are here to practice, To find the satisfaction, to be happy with the things the way are. And why are we not? Because we can't get into samadhi. We can't get the satisfaction. And then the body, itches, and then we need to scratch. It's dissatisfaction to realize the first noble truth. Dissatisfaction. And as I told you before, if there's no dissatisfaction, there's no need to do anything, there's no need to change anything. But if you are dissatisfied, of course there's constantly, anything. There's scratching, there's this, there's moving, there's moving around. Pain, dukkha. It's also dukkha. It's also dissatisfaction. We are not satisfied with the way things are. And that's why we need to change things. We need to change our position here. We need to drink something. We need to eat something. We need to sleep. Because there's dukkha. There's always involved dukkha. We need to do this. And when I go around 12 or 1 o'clock, I see a lot of monks, running around. Because of dissatisfaction with their practice. And then they find out, yeah, I need to do this, I need to do that, yeah. No. What you need to do is, yeah, stay with the Buddha or stay with the investigation, yeah. And when the sitting meditation is finished, you start your walking meditation. When the walking meditation is finished, you start your sitting meditation, yeah. Until it's time, you know, for sweeping, and then after sweeping you take a shower, and you maybe you, then you make your reflection or whatever, you know, whenever the time is right, yeah, and then you go on with the practice, yeah. There's nothing else to do, yeah. Would be nice, yeah. I mean, find the momentum that keeps you going, because otherwise, you know, you, every day is a struggle, yeah. But once the stone, starts to roll, I mean, it has its own momentum. Once the meditation is start to bringing fruits in the way, you know, of samatha or vipassana, yeah, then we don't have to worry about anything else. Yeah? We don't even want to go out. We don't even want to know what is going on in the world. Yeah? But this is something. Yeah, I mean, this is something important. Yeah, if we ever want to get out of the of samsara, yeah. We need this momentum. We need to be interested in our practice. Yeah? As long as we struggle, we don't have this momentum. Yeah? And then, the moment we have this momentum, then, you know, the fruit of our constant practice will come in. Yeah? Will just rain down on us. Yeah? But before, it's a constant struggle. Yeah. Oh, I'm too tired, yeah. Oh, it is too painful, oh, I'm thirsty, oh, I'm hungry, oh, it's too hot, oh, it's too cold, yeah. Anything, yeah. That is a struggle, yeah. So we don't have this momentum that keeps us rolling, yeah. Rolling in our practice, yeah. And not only investigation, yeah, not only samatha, but also investigation, yeah. And the daily reflection is a must, yeah, for people who are here. Yeah? Look what you're doing. Yeah? Look, you know, at the thoughts that came up in the morning or the dreams that you have, you know, and then replace them with Buddha. Yeah? Look how they color, you know, the day. Yeah, what happened, you know, what kind of mood were I in before I went to the sala? What happened before that, yeah? What kind of thoughts were there? What kind of feelings were there? And so on. Just look at them. Yeah. Don't judge them. Don't say it's good or bad. Yeah. Just look. Yeah. And then the next stop. Yeah. While I washed my face, what did I think? Yeah. When I washed my body in the afternoon, what was I thinking? Huh? What kind of feelings came up? I mean, this is important for us to know. Yeah. When I met this person, what did I think before? Yeah. Or what did I think after? Or what kind of feeling came up? And so on, and so on, and so on. Yeah? It shows us, as I said before, it is an eye-opener. It shows us what we are doing, why we are doing, and what are the results of our doing. Yeah? Otherwise, we stumble through with blindness through the world. Yeah? And hit our head here and get angry, hit our head there and get angry, you know, and get wounded and here and get wounded there, and so on, and so on. That's not the way, you know, for a practitioner. Yeah? We should try to open our eyes, and as I know myself, yeah, I mean, it is not easy. You have to have a certain determination not to be interested in anything. Then the practice starts get rolling, yeah. And once it gets rolling, you're not interested in anything, yeah. But as long as it is not rolling, you know, I mean, you have to make it roll, yeah. And then, you know, I mean, trying to change this, trying to change that, that is not going to help, yeah. That doesn't make it rolling, that keeps the ball from rolling. Yeah? Change your practice, yeah? Huh? Okay. Sitting practice, walking practice, sitting practice, walking practice, yeah? Until you go bindapat, you know, until you, after eating the food, you know, take care of the bowl and your ropes, yeah? And then sitting practice, walking practice, sitting practice, walking practice, yeah? Hopefully don't see you anywhere unless there is some work to do, yeah? When I go midday, you know, through the monastery, yeah, I don't want to see anybody, yeah? At the Namro, nor here or there, yeah? or at the office, yeah? You're supposed to practice, yeah? Isn't that why you came here? Isn't that why you're ordained? Huh? Or are you just like you consider good wood, you know, to be firewood, you know, are you just firewood, huh? Ask yourself, huh? Are you that wasteful? Huh? Or is there some hard kernel in you, you know, that is determined to practice, to overcome dukkha? Huh? Is there, yeah? Hopefully. And when you look at samatha, why are you still in the past? Why are you in the future? Huh? What is so interesting about the future that has not come? What is it that you can change in the past? Huh? What is it? Does it give you a sense of certainty? Tomorrow I'll practice, yeah? Huh? Or in 3 days I'll practice, yeah? I practice really hard, yeah? Today I'm too tired, tomorrow I'll practice. That's future, yeah? I mean, tomorrow might never come, yeah? You just might fly, die right now, yeah? And then there's no more tomorrow, and there's no more practice to go. And see, yeah? And see and realize, you know, if you're not in the future, and if you're not in the past, if you're just in the present moment, there's this feeling of uncertainty, yeah? And we try to make this, you know, and everybody in the whole world does it, yeah? We try to get over this feeling of uncertainty, what happens, yeah? By thinking about the future, yeah? And remembering the past. It's a fear, yeah? We don't know what is coming the next moment. Maybe the lightning hits us, yeah? It can happen. It did happen before. That lightning strikes a human being, yeah? This uncertainty, we have to live with it, yeah? And you will get, when you get close to samatha, when you get close to samadhi, you know, this uncertainty will come up, yeah? And actually, you know, I mean, once you get accustomed to this uncertainty, you feel free, because you don't have to think about the future. And you don't have to think about the past. You're just in this present moment. In this present moment, as I often said, yeah, is where we are actually alive, where we can make decisions. Yeah. In the future, we can't make decisions. Yeah. And if we look at our life, you know, the future that we plan to come, you know, has never arisen. Yeah. And the past that we try to change, we have to realize we can't change. But there is this uncertainty. See it, you know. I mean, see it in your daily reflection, yeah. And a lot of actions because of this uncertainty comes up, yeah. We want to overcome this uncertainty. Actually, you know, we should embrace this, yeah. It's a feeling of freedom, yeah. We don't have to do anything. Yeah? Sometimes we have to do something. Sometimes we don't have to do something. Yeah? And when we are in the present moment, in each moment, you know, there's a perfect solution for how to deal with this moment. Sometimes there's action, sometimes there's word, but most of the time there's no action and no words, yeah? But we can't see it because we plan how to say, what to say when I meet this person, what to do when I come there, what... Instead, you know, I mean, instead of looking what needs to be done, yeah? As I've seen so often with my upataks, and every one of you has been my upatak, yeah? You plan. You don't see what is necessary to do. You just go up your list, you know, this needs to be done, that needs to be done, this needs to be there, that needs to be there, is it there, yeah? And this list is not actually on paper, you know, it is in your memory, and memory is always failing, yes, yeah? Sometimes more and sometimes less, yeah? But if you would be in the present moment, I mean, how, when we open our eyes, how can we not see? Huh? How can we not see? But our fear, yeah, of forgetting something, yeah, is greater, you know. No. Be in the present moment, yeah, and learn it, yeah, and learn it through samatha. Get familiar with the present moment and see there's actually no fear. There's actually quite a lot of freedom in that. Yeah? Being in this present moment, yeah. So whatever comes, yeah. When this person comes and visits, you know, then we do this. When there's no person, yeah, we continue our work, yeah. Whatever is needed to be done. Why think about the future? Yeah? Do I get enough food tomorrow? Yeah? Maybe not. Yeah? There are some days, you know, where there's little food. There are some days where there's lots of food, yeah. Don't worry about the future. Huh? And don't think about the past. Yeah? Live from moment to moment, yeah. And then also see that our life is, you know, is not a continuation, it's actually a moment, after one moment, after one moment, yeah, just like a moving picture, yeah. Every moment of our life is a picture, yeah. And we put them together and then see, you know, oh, there we laugh, oh, there we jump, oh, there we run, oh, there we walk, oh, there we sit, you know, oh, there we drink, yeah. And then put this movie together so that it makes some sense. Yeah? But actually, you know, it is from moment to moment, yeah. Being alive in one moment. And see this insecurity, yeah. I mean, it's a big, yeah, it's just like a wanting to change a dissatisfaction when dissatisfaction arises, yeah. I mean, insecurity is also not a nice feeling. It's also, you know, considered dukkha, yeah. See it when it comes up, yeah, and then just stay with it, yeah. Just like we do with feelings, yeah. We observe the feeling, yeah. And let it pass. Just like we observed, you know, just before it was raining, we observed the thunder and the lightning, you know, and we observed the rain, and now it's gone. Yeah, it's passing. Everything is passing away. Everything is anicca. Yeah? Everything, all these things that are anicca are anatta. Yeah? They're not me. Yeah, the clouds, the rain clouds are not me, are not mine, are not myself. Yeah. They just come and they go, just like feelings come and go. See it, yeah? See it in your reflection. You know, these feelings have nothing to do with, yeah? Or very little to do with what you do, yeah? It has much to do with what we think and what we memorize, yeah? That's where the feelings come up, yeah? See it. Open the eyes, please. And develop a little bit of wisdom. Now, yeah. What do you think? Shall I treat you as firewood? Huh? I mean, wood can be very useful. You can build a lot of things. Yeah, you can even build, you know, the gate that leads you out of dukkha. Yeah, if it's just firewood, you know, I mean, you stay. Yeah, you stay there. Yeah. You stay there in the samsara. You've been burned and burned and burned again, and then come back to life, then burned again, then come back to life, then burned again. Huh? That's firewood, yeah? Useless, yeah? So, you understand? We cannot bear the uncertainty of a situation. We have to fix our mind on it. What am I going to? I mean, look at your own thoughts, you know, over the past few years, yeah. What am I going to do if the situation happened? You already plan. What am I going to do if that situation happened? We already plan. What am I going to do when that situation happened? We already plan. And most of the time, none of these situations come, and another situation comes, and then we haven't planned for it. And then we start, yeah. But if we live to live in each situation, you know. Yeah. But we can't bear this uncertainty. We have to have a plan. We have to have a condition. That's why, do you understand now why I call you robots? Yeah? Robots are programmed to handle, you know, this situation, they handle it like this, that situation, they handle it like that. Yeah? And if the situation, if the handling is not correct, you change the program, yeah? But you're still a robot. It's the most difficult thing for us to live in this uncertainty, you know, of events. But actually, when once you embrace this uncertainty, you will feel free. Because most of the time there's nothing to do. Yeah? And when you look, yeah, and it takes a little while, you know, I mean, it takes a little bit step forward. Okay, let's try it out, you know. And then you get a taste of it and say, actually, it's much better than when I have planned it. Yeah? And then you see it, then you take the next step, you know, until you get more and more comfortable to live in this uncertainty. Yeah? And then there's no more conditioning. You lessen the conditioning, and the more you lessen the conditioning, the more free you are. Yeah? You don't have to react in a certain way. You don't have to play, you know, like Shakespeare, you don't have to play this role. You don't have to play the role of a father. You don't have to play the role of a son. You don't have to play the role of an employee. Or you don't have to play the role of a teacher or whatever you are. Yeah? Because it's all role-playing. Yeah? And role-playing is nothing else than conditioning. But it takes a while. And the things, this uncertainty, yeah, is a ghost coming. Huh? I better put on my light in my kuti. Yeah? Maybe a ghost is coming. Yeah? Something like that. And it's fear. Yeah? And fear is the thing, you know, I mean, that we should really investigate. Yeah? What is fear? You know, where is it coming from? From these kind of projection that we do with our thinking. No? Just sit, you know, in the night, in the middle of the night, yeah? And then you hear a sound. Well, what is going to happen within you? So you assess all the situation. Is it a snake? Is it a rat? Is it this? Or is it that? Yeah? Huh? And then you think, you know, of the worst thing that possible. Yeah? It's a snake. Yeah? And then you push your light on and it was a little gecko. Yeah? And ching chong. Yeah? Wasn't even anything. Yeah? But, I mean, you see it's all in your mind because you really don't know. Because you're really uncertain of the things, you know, I mean, you don't know. Yeah? If you say don't know, you know, okay. Then you don't know. Yeah? And if you don't know, then there shouldn't be any fear. Fear comes through labeling. Yeah? Fear comes through, you know, this experience, you know, what am I going to do? Yeah? Because we have to have a solution for everything, yeah, in our life. And we know how well it worked out. That's why we are here, because it didn't work out. That's why we're here, because our programming didn't work out, yeah? And if some of our people, you know, some of our friends, you know, relatives, you know, or colleagues, yeah? I mean, their programming is so bad, you know, they need to go to see a psychiatrist that changed their program so they can live back in the world, yeah? Programming never works out, yeah? I mean, it makes, you know, most of the people, yeah, I mean, they just go apart, you know, okay, yeah, more or less, yeah. But every one of us faces, you know, really difficulties, really hard times. And we don't know how to cope with it, yeah. So we take books, you know, how to cope with this situation. That is his solution. Our solution is completely different. Okay, understood?